Hey gang, Jason here for the love of tractors, and I am with the John Deere 2510H. This is the applicator set with the wagons. So I think this is really kind of more of a toy. So it says replica play, so yeah, whatever. But I wanted one because I want to customize this thing, and then I thought I'd also do a quick review on it real quick here. So I'm going to get this out of the box. All right, so already first impression is there's way more die-cast in this than I thought. So all of this frame is die-cast, and a lot of this main frame, actually, you know what? All of the main frame here, and then it looks like the only plastic are wings here. So that's super cool. Of course, this is plastic. The real thing's plastic. Why wouldn't it be? So, here we go. Here's what it looks like. So it's got cylinders on there, of course, typical of a toy. They're oversized. They've got to be durable, but they're there, so that's a huge bonus. Front wheels, these do not raise and lower, so, you know, that's, I guess, an area of improvement for customizers like myself. Wheels look pretty decent, though. I don't know, those are maybe off like an 8000 series, I think, but they look good. Check this out. Ladder, up, down, up and down, so that's cool. Potential there, you know, I'm definitely seeing like handrails on this around this, down the ladder maybe. You've got your pump system here, and then of course a nice hitch back there. You know, you could definitely do a more detailed wheel. I think these wheels would look fine if you just actually painted these center hubs so they don't look like plastic. Row units look decent though on this, don't they? I think so. I mean, for a toy, you know, that's not bad at all. There's a little detail there, of course. If you wanted to get real crazy and customize and put new row units on there, you certainly could. One of the big things that detracts from this whole thing are the giant rivets that hold the row units on. You know, if you painted those green, they'd be certainly less noticeable. So I guess that's an idea as well. So look at that, fits right in my track there into my muddy field. So then you got your anhydrous tank. This is actually the whole reason I wanted this whole set. So this thing's got room for customization for sure. I'm kind of disappointed these are built in because I was hoping I can pop those off and put some that don't look quite as chunky on there. But all in all, looks pretty good. I love the wheels and tires on this. They're kind of big and beefy. They're kind of like a turf type road tire. I'll see if I can get you some tread detail there. They look all right. Dang it, there we go. They look all right. So these tanks are just screwed to this frame, so if you wanted to remove those to do something, it'd be pretty easy to do. Possibly, I don't know, it's got a lot of decaling on it, you could probably, but you could remove those and paint those, make them look a little less like plastic on there. Hitch is decent, it, you know, swivels around all the way, and very easily. This thing rolls great. Let's put the whole thing together back here. Yeah, see, the whole thing is just, that's great. That's certainly good for a from a toy standpoint, I guess. So it'd be excellent for, you know, kids to play with. That does fold down all the way, despite not having it folded down all the way. I don't know. Let's put it on my New Holland. Of course, the hitch won't work on that because I have a realistic hitch on my New Holland, and this is, of course, the toy hitch. But gosh, that's pretty neat. I like that. I like that a lot. That's a cool little setup. It's pricey booger. Not gonna sugarcoat that. Around $30. $30 to $35 is what they were going for at St. Louis. So that's what you're gonna be into if you want one of these. With that said, it's not like there are too many application outfits on the market. So there is that. And like I said, this is a great toy. I think it's very rugged. Kids could easily play with this thing, not have any trouble at all. So, I don't know, that's kind of my thoughts. Good customization potential definitely there, or at least I think so. And like I said, looks great on the New Holland there. So, all right, guys. So there's the first toy I bought at St. Louis. Well, the first toy I'm doing a video of from St. Louis. as you guys, if you saw the other St. Louis video, you know I've got a few more to come. So we'll hit those up as the days go along here. So, anyway, appreciate you guys watching. As always, please do that like, share, subscribe thing. It helps out big time, especially if you guys can get out on social media and share this stuff. So, all right, guys, thanks for watching. Have yourselves a great day. Happy tractor hunting. Catch you later.